Hello, my dear students. Welcome once again in my YouTube channel. So in this video lecture, I am going to tell you about mechanism of hearing. In my last lecture, we have discussed about human ear structure. So in this lecture, I am going to tell you how we are able to hear. So in this lecture, we are going to discuss about all the mechanisms. So as the sound waves enters through the external ear, we have discussed three parts of ear, that is external ear, middle ear and internal ear. So these are the three parts of the ear. We have discussed in detail all the structures. So as the sound waves enter the external ear, they pass through ear canal. You can say ear canal as auditory canal. So I have made a flow chart here. So in this flow chart, you can able to see sound waves at pinna. This you can mark as number one. Okay. And yes, as the sound waves at the ear pinna passes through the auditory canal, then it will strike at the eardrum, which is called as tympanic membrane. So you can mark here one, this is number two, and this is number three. These all processes are taking sequentially. So it will strike the at the eardrum, and the vibrations of the eardrums are transmitted to the three ear ossicles. We have discussed these three ear ossicles, that is the malleus, incus and stapes. We have discussed about malleus, incus and stapes. These are the ear ossicles, and these are the ear ossicles through which we can magnify 20 to 25 times by their lever like actions. So what will happen after this? As the stapes fit into the oval window, here the perilymph of cochlea, there is a fluid which is called as perilymph in the vestibular canal. You can write here as a vestibular canal. So vestibular canal, through which this perilymph in the cochlea, it passes and also vibrates, and it will cause the round window to move to and fro. And what will happen after this? These vibrations cause the movement of basilar membrane, like endolymph, which in turn move the sensory hair cells, and the organ of Corti is attached to it, creating the nerve impulse. And these sound waves, these are converted to nerve impulses. They will travel through the auditory nerve to the auditory cortex, and that is the region of brain. And the variations in the intensity and pitch are determined by the amplitude of the basilar membrane. It will vibrate, and at this basilar membrane, finally at the perilymph tympanic canal, there will be vibration at round window and sound waves that will be dissipated through all the middle ear parts and finally at the region of organ of Corti. So in summary, we can say that all the events in the middle ear that leads to generation of nerve impulse, you can write in this way: all the vibrations in the endolymph, vibration in endolymph, and then vibrations of basilar membrane, vibrations of basilar membrane, I am writing BM here. And then stimulation of organ of Corti stimulates organ of Corti, that is organ of Corti. And next, impulse will be transmitted to the auditory nerve. Impulse transmit hoke jayengi. Impulse will be transmitted. Auditory nerve, which is basically related to hearing, and finally auditory nerve that will carry the impulse. This auditory nerve, they will carry impulse, and ye jo impulse honge kahan se kahan jayenge students? Auditory impulses cochlea se isko hume lekar jana hoga auditory cortex of brain ka. From cochlea to auditory cortex of brain. So this is all about the hearing mechanism. So this is not too much important for your board examination. So for your examination, you have to focus on human eye structure. Human ear is not too much important for your board exams, but for your understanding, this video will be helpful for all of you. So I hope we will meet soon with a new video, and tab tak ke liye bye bye, take care.